Yes, sir, we promised you a great main event tonight.
Andre, the China.
WrestleMania!
Hulkamania is running west.
My God, what a
join WWE and THQ in creating SmackDown vs. Raw 2009. Beginning with SmackDown for the original PlayStation, THQ's sports entertainment simulation has become a global phenomenon, evolving into the mega-popular, best-selling SmackDown vs. Raw franchise. This year brings gamers the 10th iteration of the successful franchise, SmackDown vs. Raw 2009, and it promises to be the best version yet. A number of major upgrades have been made, including enhanced graphics, an updated roster, and a much improved feature set. THQ is dedicated to bringing gamers more fan service than ever before, with more match types, gameplay innovations, and more customization. Since SmackDown vs. Raw 2009 is targeted at you, the WWE fan, to make such a game, it takes the dedication and vision of exactly that, the fans.
This is the beginning.
We start out with a pre-production phase. This is where we think of the concepts that we want in the game. We usually have a lot of brainstorming sessions with the designers, and we think about what would be fun for the user, the fans, what they're expecting to see in the game. Really, fan feedback is our most important and most utilized tool. We really like to search the message boards and the forums to find out what the fans want.
Our fans are the greatest fans in the world, and we want to provide them with a great product every year. And so we're always struggling with how to get as much new and exciting content in the limited amount of time that we have to produce it.
Definitely take their feedback into account. We actually get fan mail. We actually get mail with suggestions and whatnot, and we always are on the message board seeing like how everyone's reacting to the new features, what they'd like changed.
Once we establish our feature set and really find out what the fans want, we go ahead and send those over to our developer, Yuke's. And they go ahead and come up with strategies for how they're going to code it and implement it into the game.
My primary job is to research the latest technology available for SmackDown vs. Raw on the PlayStation 3 game console. Figure out what other types of innovations are out there on the market and how we are going to use those technologies to improve the gameplay for SmackDown vs. Raw.
We look at, well, what does the Japanese development team do really good that we can't do? And what do we do well that the Japanese guys aren't so good at? And we split the work up that way, and it's a really good collaboration now.
You know, we try and draft off what they're doing, and then we have to innovate technology, new animation systems, new things online. So it's a combination of taking their innovation and having us innovate both in terms of technology and gameplay modes so that when that fan again fires up the next version of the game, it's an all-new experience.
Usually the first 4 or 5 months are strictly pre-production, where we work on the designs of the game, we go to motion capture shoots, and we shoot the animations that we want for the games.
A client comes to us, they have a video game idea, they've worked it out, planned it out, know all the levels that they need, they know all the in-game moves that they need, they know all the cinematics that they need, and they come to us with 1,500 to 2,000 moves. And then in terms of cinematics, probably 16 to 20 scenes. And we help the client achieve that by getting them through the day. And you know, we can get through 200 shots a day, 200 to 300.
Creating video game is a very detailed process. The part of this process that I was impressed with the most, I mean, the way they capture the motion of the athletes, that's a whole other art in itself. Motion capture, I believe it's called.
Basically, we have a marker set of 59 markers, and what we do is we put them on spandex suits. And once they go out into what we call the volume, which is the capture area, the cameras emit an infrared ray, and that ray lights up the marker. You've got these 3D points in space, And what we do is reconstruct those points into a skeleton. And what we do is we stream this skeleton to that 3D package motion builder, and we connect it, and therefore we're able to make 3D models move.
We basically become all of the roster, whoever they need us for. We do, not only do we do moves, but we do entrances. It's very hard because everybody has their own little mannerisms. So you try to capture all that because of all these sensors, they pick up hand movements, head movements, everything. You want to try to get it right so it looks exact in the video game.
The motion capture is always accurate. They have chronicled so many moves over the years that legitimately the library is thousands long. But the way they delegate the moves to certain superstars is they truly give superstars the moves that they use in the ring. You won't see me doing any sort of high flyer Rey Mysterio type stuff or any sort of Great Khali giant moves. I do what I do from my perspective. I'm a fighter. I have a couple pretty cool things.
That combined with the sound effects, with the digital appearance of the person, and put it together, it's like you're controlling life.
It's quite a lengthy process to create the actual superstars in the game. First, we start with their models. In order to create their models, we need some really detailed information on the look of the actual superstar. So we have a lot of photo shoots where we get probably any angle and a picture imaginable of the superstar.
The scanning process for the video game was something very creepy. First, you walk into this dark track, and there's these guys, they're like machine operators, like freaks, like computer freaks. And you sit in this chair, you can't move. If they tell you if you move, we have to do it again and again, so you don't want to move. And this machine, she goes around you, the lasers on you, and scans you to three-dimensional pictures. It's crazy.
They try to get all the characteristics. They try to get tattoos. They try to get, you know, your bone structure, even the smallest details, the arch of your eyebrows, the color of your eyes.
So once we gather all that information, we go ahead and we give it to the developer, Yuke, and they can go ahead and start working on the model, creating the model structure, and then adding the textures to it, and then polishing it up. And then at that point, we review it, we make sure it's very authentic, it looks just like that superstar. So from beginning to end, the creation of a model usually takes about, I would say, 6 to 8 weeks.
We look to make sure that everything's functioning correctly, and if the textures are stretching or giving some kind of appearance we're not happy with. And here we can see, so we're pretty content with the way it's moving in the cheekbones and areas like that, and even the nose moves a little bit, which is something that it's a nuance that happens in humans that you often don't notice it. And if it isn't there in the 3D, you'll say that looks very odd. I'm not happy with the way that guy is moving or behaving, and you don't know why. And it's because of things like that. When we talk, our body parts do move slightly, and that's, we need to emulate that as much as we can within our limits in making this game. And that's why we have these tests that we do for each character.
Every year they seem to get more and more close to the real thing. It looks now like a Monday Night Raw broadcast on HD.
The technology is just one of the many things that goes into making SmackDown vs. Raw one of the top quality games that it is, because it really captures the realism of all of your favorite WWE superstars.
It's really cool how lifelike and how close to reality these video games have become. Like, it just, technology is amazing.
The detail of this game is unbelievable. It shows every ripped muscle that Santino Marella has. It shows my love handles too, but I talked to the guys. They're going to take it off with the computer.
Ready?
Roll it.
Okay.
No, don't start. Don't give me a headache with your dim-witted questioning. This is a time of celebration.
The THU voiceover process is something that just adds to the realness of the game. It takes the actual voice of the superstars, we go into an audio booth, and we read progressive storylines that are possibilities in the game. Now you have to do multiple storylines because it's kind of like a choose your own adventure, so you don't necessarily know where the gamer will end up.
This is a 3-month road for a player to take one of the most popular superstars in the WWE and take their path, their road to WrestleMania. When you play as John Cena, you'll be playing as if you were John Cena himself, and all the storylines will revolve around him.
I want you all to know that I'm very happy to be in New York City, and I'm sure to give Mr. Kennedy a fight he'll never forget.
It takes the better half of a day, and everybody kind of just goes in and does their thing.
I know what you're going to ask, and the answer is no. I'm not worried. WrestleMania will end the same way it began, with me as World Heavyweight Champion.
The storyline makes you feel like you're being immersed in that WWE world.
Doing voiceovers for SmackDown versus Raw is a lot of fun.
It's almost like being in a prison riot.
When I'm doing voiceovers, it's helpful to close your eyes and envision you're at ringside.
And we're officially underway in this ECW Extreme Rules Triple Threat match.
We want them to have the best experience possible.
How humiliating!
You get to have a lot of fun with it. They get a lot of different takes, whether some are out of control, some are more reserved. But it all makes sense when the game comes together. It's another one of those things that THQ just leaps and bounds everybody else on.
What we have to do to keep winning over time is to keep innovating. New characters, new storylines, new modes.
Every year we're constantly coming up with innovative ways to market the product and improving the product. This is our 10th year for SmackDown vs. Raw in the franchise, so it's a very exciting year for us. It's a big milestone. So really we want to blow out the feature set this year, have a lot of features that fans have been asking for. So some of the big features that fans can expect this year are the Create a Finisher mode, which is a big mode for us, and it lets users construct any finisher imaginable. Users can go into this interface, link together animations, and really create any finisher imaginable. What's really great about this is it kind of completes the Create a Superstar package.
Our create modes have always been fantastic. Our Create a Superstar is incredibly deep. And year over year, our Create a Superstar mode has been incredibly popular.
Everyone wants to see themselves involved in the experience that they're having. So even with our game SmackDown versus Raw, we have the Create a Superstar mode. Most people create themselves and then put themselves into the game and experience the game as themselves. I myself do exactly the same thing.
Now they're able to apply a whole new move to that character, a move that no one's ever seen before with our Create a Finisher move.
Another big feature we're adding this year is the replay system, something we're calling the WWE Highlight Reel. What this allows you to do is, during your matches, you can record footage in that match, and you can collect this footage and make your own highlight reel in our editing tool. This editing tool lets you take together these pieces of the highlights and slice them together and create whatever highlight package you want. And we also have a lot of other bells and whistles you can add on there, such as audio, such as different kind of effects you can add, different camera placements, and the total package you end up creating is your own WWE highlight reel, that superstar. So say, for instance, I can play with John Cena, I can get all his best moves, I can do some high-flying moves off ladders and tables, I can record that, and I can edit it together to create a John Cena highlight reel. What's really cool about that is I create my own highlight reel, I can go ahead and upload it online and show my friends, show other users across the world my version of the John Cena highlight reel.
You can make your own WWE highlight reel and show off to everyone online how great of a superstar you are, and not only make fun of your friends in your own living room, you can show the whole world how great you are.
Our next big feature is the all-new tag team match.
We're really blowing out the tag team functionality. In the past, it was fun to play against your friend, but now you can play with your friend. We're really kind of expanding on tag team moves, tag team finishers, our first ever co-op storyline, which is incredibly exciting.
SmackDown vs. Raw, the franchise, is all about multiplayer gaming. Fans love to get their buddies together and have a multiplayer session where they can play a lot of different matches. And really, tag team match is one of the most popular multiplayer matches. So we really wanted to overhaul this match, do it justice in the game. So we've added a bunch of new features that not only bring back the drama of tag team match, but also encourage you to work as a team. So some of those features will be new abilities you and your partner can do in the match, such as distracting the referee. Now the illegal partner can go ahead and grab the referee, distract him, and let your partner in the ring go ahead and maybe do some dirty tactics like use a chair on his opponent to get the win. A lot of those features encourage cooperation, working as a team, and allows the match to have a little bit more drama as well. So now when you distract the referee and you use a weapon, the drama is heightened in the match. There's a risk there of being DQ'd or not being DQ'd. So
We like to add a lot of those features that really kind of heighten the drama and encourage you to work as a team.
It's a lot more of an interactive way to play tag teams than before, where you're really playing, and it's not just like one guy's just sitting there kind of twiddling his thumbs waiting for the tag to come into the match. You're both taking part in the tag team match, and it's a whole lot of fun. So it's a new, fun kind of cooperative play that's really enhanced over what we've had in the past.
The Inferno match, the brand new match type we're adding this year, it puts two wrestlers in a ring surrounded by fire, and the first person to make their opponent burn is the winner. So it's a very gruesome match. It's a match that fans have seen on WWE programming, but yet they've yet to see it in our game. So we're very excited to be able to introduce that new match this year. We think fans will be very excited about it. And it's also got a very cool visual presentation with the ring surrounded by fire. And each time you do big moves, the fire will grow. There's a lot of danger involved there. There's gonna be a lot of drama in there. You're really gonna have to fight hard to get your opponent over to the fire and to burn for that victory. Our last big feature is our online functionality that we're adding this year. The online community is something that's very important to us. We want to continue to grow that and support online as much as we can. And one of the big features we're talking about for online is downloadable content. They can go ahead and download new content to keep the game fresh, to keep the game up to date.
THQ has done such a good job integrating online play, creating your own championships, life outside the ring. They've done it all. And I look forward to the release of the new games just to see what they'll come up with next.
Our game comes out, we take a little breather at the end, but the fans never stop. They keep playing, they keep on wanting more, and we do our best to give them what they want.
It's funny, each year we get done, I'm like, oh, what else can we do? And then somehow we accomplish, you know, making the game better and better.
We see the passion of the fans, and that passion rubs off on us. What can we come up with that excites the fans? We really wanted to make sure we're delivering a AAA game, so we always want to push the envelope, not just with wrestling, but with multiplayer gaming, with fighting games, with sports games. We just want to be the franchise that's out there that's pushing the envelope, that's delivering a great experience every single year.